motion to receive and file the May 2019 paid invoice report. Any questions for Jason? Item number 10 is a motion to receive and file May 2019 budget performance report. Any questions for Mr. Coacher on that? Item number 11 is a motion to approve July 2019 payroll. Any questions on that? Item 12 is a motion to approve a permit for Elliot's Amusement to hold a carnival at the Taylor Summer Festival from June 27th through the 30th, 2019. All city requirements to obtain a carnival permit have been met. Any questions on that? Item 13 is a motion to approve the purchase of laptops to be utilized as electronic poll books through CW-G, low quote, in the amount not to exceed $4,750, funds to be allocated through general fund, clerk's office, voting equipment.
Chairman, we received the original laptop in 2013, and with redistricting, we moved down to 23 precincts, so I had some spares to utilize it. So they're getting older and more functioning, as well as things like back in 2018, so we replaced a few. So this is to replace, we don't have a new start coming in, so that we don't have any breakdown for the 2020 election cycle.
Right now, and I'll buy more.
Just a small budget, and I'll buy next year. Any other questions? How many laptops do we use?
23.
Okay. What is one for every?
One for every three things, yes.
Oh, yes, 29.
Yeah, 9 this collection, or this fiscal year, and then I'll purchase more. Like I said, the majority of them, we had no issues, but there were a couple of places where we had to run new ones out because they're starting to fail. And they were originally given to us by the state to get us to go to the electronic poll book versus the paper poll books. And now they're, you know, we could go back to the paper poll books if we, but they're not going to give us any more for free. We're on our own now.
Item 14 is a motion to approve payments of one beacon in the amount of $151,384 for a two-year extended reporting period from May 9, 2019 through May 8, 2021, paid by Nickel and Saph, Inc., City's agent of record, to be funded from General Fund Risk Management Contractual Services. Sheila sent us an email. She could not be here today. But from what I gathered, it's kind of a bridge. For a time, we don't seem to have any coverage from that time, so this will cover us in that.
Until the end.
Yeah, until the end.
Why
do
we get cover letters late?
What's that?
Why do we get cover letters late?
She apologized, but yeah, that was brought up. Yeah.
We're going to get an email from the meeting. From that.
Right.
She wanted an application this week.
Just so everybody knows, cover letters are required, please. Item 15 is a motion. Oh, did anybody have any questions on that? Sorry. Item 15 is a motion to approve payment in the amount of $11,700 to National Faith Homebuyers for the down payment assistance for homebuyers. Number 2019-05 and 2019-06, funded through the home grant. Mr. Hall?
The two applicants who we all look at are with the down payment.
Is there any questions on that? Item 16 is a motion to approve setting a public hearing for the July 2nd, 2019 at the regularly scheduled city council meeting. The public hearing will allow the public input in regards to the presented community development block grant action plan budget for the 2019-2020 program year. Mr. Paul?
The chairman is setting a public hearing. So we'll be presenting to you with a plan, budget for our action plan within the next week or so for your review. It will look a little different. We're also going to have to set some public hearings after that to move some current funding. With all the home sales in the last year, we've received a lot of program income. So with that, you have to spend that first before you start to spend your grant funds. So we're so heavily funded in things like home rehab that has lower funded in other places. We're going to ask your approval to do some final work.
Okay.
I will give you ample time to do that.
Okay. Is there any other questions on that? Yeah, item 17 is a motion to approve PCMG low quote for firewall support renewal for an amount not to exceed $6,429 funded through IT contractual services. Mr. Seehaw?
Thank you, Chairman. This is the regular firewall maintenance. This includes the city hall and also the library firewall. Normally, the library has separate board, but being a same vendor, we just put it together on approval. The other point to be noted is this firewall we bought about 6 years ago. Normally, every 6 years, five to six years, we do review the firewall vendor, see what's out there. So next year, we'll be reviewing that and also recommend the new purchase or continue on with the same vendor. So we'll do that evaluation next year.
It's the
$6,000
on the $4,000.
So on the cover sheet, it says $4,882, but on the agenda, it's $6,429. Which one's the correct price?
$6,429.
Okay. So we'll have to amend that on the...
What is it right in the agenda?
Right in the agenda.
It's right on the agenda.
It's right on the agenda. We're on the cover sheet, so just...
6-4.
So we don't need one.
The budget sheet shows $4,000, so purchasing put the wrong amount because the $4,000 obviously was, they didn't meet bid specifications. I don't know if they see behind it, so. So you must have put the $4,000 on there too, so I don't know.
What's right on the agenda, so. Any questions on that? Okay, number 18, motion to approve integration partners sole source for network management suite software maintenance under special manufacturer promotion for an amount not to exceed $8,800 funded through IT contractual services.
Another one with other.
Yeah, I just mentioned that too.
Correct. Cover sheet is not there, sorry. It was last minute that we had to put it in on Wednesday to push it through. And I can explain a little bit more on that, but I apologize for not.
Do you have one for it that you can send for
us? You can send it, I can send it.
Okay, appreciate that.
Just to the, a little bit more information on this item, the product, the network management suite we got through Avaya in 2011 as a also promotional item. We got a bunch of wireless hardware and the network suite that can manage the network and wireless. In 2011, it was around about 90% discount rate. Since then, we've been using this product on a wireless portfolio and also on the network portfolio. The problem happened with when Avaya got sold and bought out by Extreme Networks, which is the current vendor. Last couple of meetings that will be approved, the maintenance contract, which is our network provider now. Mm-hmm. So when they bought Avaya out, they are not, because they are having the same product, they're not keeping the one of the network suite management product in a portfolio. So if this promotion wasn't there, we would be end up buying $45,000 product through, which it would give us a discount about 40 to 50%, but still we end up paying $25,000 plus the maintenance after that.
So they bought the program and they're basically eliminating that, so everybody would go to theirs.
Bought the company.
They bought it.
How it works is most of these wireless systems is owned by one or two companies in the world. The rest of the vendors like Avaya and Cisco and all these network people, they buy the lease rights.
Okay.
So when these companies buy each other out, they don't want to pay the royalty of the different programs, so they discontinue, because they're already paying the royalty on their network program.
So they're giving us their comparable program.
Correct.
Correct.
So what happens, so they, for the customer like us, they don't want to make us unhappy. So they created a promotional offer, which ends in June, stating that, okay, if you do it, you don't have to purchase. As long as you pay the 1 year maintenance, we'll give you two years of maintenance, which is really, really good deal for us. And we don't want to let it go, these promotions, because if the promotion is not there, we end up buying this for $20,000, $25,000 plus paying the maintenance.
Any questions on that?
Another key point is being the sole source. Technically, this kind of product like maintenance, normally a lot of vendors can sell, but this promotion specifically talks about the promotion would be only rendered to the company that we bought. We bought it through, which is IBC. So that's the only reason being a sole source. Other one. And plus the other one is last minute, we would not have time to go out and request three bids. Probably won't come back, and by the time this thing would expire anyway. So those are the two reasons we end up putting it in a sole source.
Is there any questions? Okay, if not, item 19 is a motion to approve fiscal year 2018-2019 budget amendment number 2019-016. Mr. Kocher?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. Similar to prior years, the fiscal year end is June 30th. So prior to then, I did an analysis in beginning of June for the last meeting in June to go over any kind of potential budget items that need to be addressed so that we can address them, because we cannot adjust the budget after June 30th for this fiscal year. And a couple of the items that are addressing is like, what I do is I go down, look at all the funds, look at departments, and when there's a potential department that may be over budget, we come to council with a potential budget amendment for those items so that we don't go over budget for the fiscal year. A couple of things were timing differences between when we did the omnibus budget amendment to current situation, and a couple of things have changed. So what you have here are those proposed amendments for the fiscal year. So again, not actually not as loud as we had in prior years, which is nice, but there are some, you know, there are some things that we need